In today's video, I'm gonna design a very simple game within the Figma design, and then I'm gonna do the vibe coding and convert that design into the real functional game using ChatGPT, Claude, and Figma Make. So get sure to watch this video until the end if you wanna see what is the result. My name is Kia, and here's a Kimo. Welcome to my channel. Share my experience doing these things with you directly, that you can see also what are the possibilities and how is going to be the result.
The game that I want to make in this video is the Timberman, one of the very old arcade game that you might be familiar with. The mechanism of the game is very simple. Players need to chop off the tree. They can hit the tree from right side or from the left side. The only challenge that exists is that they should not touch the branches of the tree. So if the branch is in the left side, they should hit the tree from right and other way around. Game also has a timer that whenever the time finishes, the game is going to be over, and players can add up on their time by hitting the tree. So let's start the process by designing all the visual assets that we need for our game, such as the character itself or the tree. I'm gonna do this in the Figma design. In Figma design, I switch to the Figma draw because I have access to more tools which will help me to create my illustration. First, I'm gonna make the basic shape, such as a square. I change the color to something more close to the wood. Then I will pick up the pen tool from the toolbar and create some line and add some effect to the stroke. In this way, I would like to create a wood texture. When I had the line with this rock effect, I will move the point of this vector shape left and right to create a random look and feel. Then I will use the variable width to increase or reduce the width of the line in different points on its own path. The rest of the process is easy. I just want to create the texture, so I will copy paste these lines and then position them in different places of this wood block. We can make a duplication of these blocks and adjust the texture lines in order to make them look more random. I would like to give these blocks a 3D effect. To do that, I'm gonna add a gradient effect in the fill section to this shape. To be honest, designing the illustration is not the main part of this video. Most important thing is that you should make some reference image, reference illustration, and later on we use these references to feed the AI and ask the AI to generate our game based on the reference images that we have. Later on you will see that how Figma Make is going to use exactly the things that we design within the game. I keep my illustrations very simple. I don't want to spend so much time to create high quality and high detail illustrations, but if you have done the same, share your design with me. I want to know what you have done. These two blocks are actually the same, so I'm gonna make a component set and then define one properties to have control on the different variants of this component set. So in this way, if I add one instance of this block, I can switch between different variants easily. I will go back to the Figma draw and pick up my pen tool. This time I want to create one line and use the same technique that I use in order to create the wood texture to make our branches. I make one variant for the branches in the left and one variant for the branches in the right side. Then of course I make a component set with these two variants. And the rest is easy. I'm gonna use the instances of these two components that we made in order to create the whole wood block or the tree blocks. I'm gonna speed up this part. Okay, that's it. If we stack these blocks on top of each other, it's gonna give us kind of a feeling that this is a, I don't know, a tree or something like that. Now, let's start designing our character. For the character, I'm gonna use the same techniques. I'm gonna switch to the Figma draw. I'm gonna use the basic shapes to create the body, and then I use the design panel and the properties that exist there to add color, effects, and everything else that is needed to create my character. We can add legs, arms, hands, neck, and then the head and face. Feel free to add more details and work more on this illustration if you're working on the same design. Before we forget, we also need to design one axe, which we will give to this character. The game is about chopping the tree, so we need this. We have the tree, we have the character. Now I will make a new frame and add these two into that frame to create my final scene. I will use this image or this frame as a reference when I want to start the vibe coding. I create a bunch of instances of the component that we had, the character itself, the tree block, and then I'm gonna move them into our frame. Then I will scale them and get sure that they are in a proper position. Then we can add the ground with the grass effect, or we can add a sky, so give more detail to the scene. But it's really up to you. You can create your design in the way that you want. Figma Make is going to be the first tool that I want to try in this video. So I'm going to take everything that we have, copy and paste it into my chat in the Figma Make, and write down one prompt to give more explanation of what exactly I want to achieve. Let's give it a try and see how it's going to work. Let's open the Figma Make. I will switch back to Figma Design. Then I will select the reference frame that we made, use the combination key Ctrl-C or Command-C, and then paste that frame within my chat using the combination key Ctrl or Command-V. It is that simple, so we don't have to really export our asset and then import it again. Using ChatGPT, I created also one prompt to back up my visualization. This prompt is explaining every detail about the game itself, like the mechanism or everything that should happen and the logic of the game. In the chat, we can see that Figma started to think. This process might take a couple of seconds or minutes. It depends on the difficulty and complexity of our task. Meanwhile, if you switch to the code tab, you can see the code that the Figma Make is generating. Plus, you have access to directory of your project, so you can see the folders and the files that has been generated. Are you ready for the first result? Let's check it out. Already, I see that we have some user interface element within the game, which is very impressive. Then let's click on the start the game. We see the tree, and the first thing I notice is that the tree that we see in the scene is kind of coming from the Figma, so I designed it myself. It's very similar. Plus the branches, the character is a little bit broken, but the logic is also working well, so we can switch the character to the left and right. That's already good. Actually, it's very impressive that Figma Make really used the asset that I provided to it. For example, the body of the tree is using the wood block that I made. But the logic of the game is not working, so let's fix some stuff up and then see how we can continue. So first thing I notice is that there are more than 10 warnings for our project that might cause that issue within the logic of the game. So I'm going to solve all of them by clicking on this button, Fix for Me. In this way, the AI is going to pick up all the warnings and try to find a solution for them. However, I fail again. After fixing all the warnings, the logic of the game does not work well. This time, I'm going to try directly to write down one prompt, ask the AI to solve the problems. Okay, it was our second try, and now our game is working. So the logic is there, the user interface elements are there, characters and all the illustrations are in their own place. Now the logic of the game is also working a little bit better, but I want to push this one step further. I want to force the Figma Make to use the exact character that I provided to it. So let's see if it's working. I switch back to the Figma design and copy the frame that has the character within it. Then come back to the Figma Make and I paste that frame within my chat. Plus, I write down one prompt to explicitly ask the AI to replace the character that exists within the game with the one that I provided. And let's play the game again. And here we go. We have our character, exactly the same thing that we designed within the Figma here. Actually, I did not check the code to see if it is the SVG format of the design that we had, or it's using just a PNG. But the fact that it's picking up that design and placing it within our game is already very good. I've noticed that the Figma Make also generated a responsive layout for our game, meaning that if we change the size of the viewport of our preview canvas, we can also see the touchscreen controller in the bottom right and left side of the screen. That was it. Now I have my character within the game. I just spent half an hour to do this, so it's amazing to see how the result is working. But now let's go one step further. I want to add some cool effects, some Wii effects to the game to make it more interesting. Let's see what Figma Make can do for us. I'm going to keep it simple. Just going to write down one simple prompt and ask that I want to see more cool effects and animations within this game. And let's speed up the coding part and see the result. And here we go. With only one prompt, we add a lot of cool animations, such as the falling animation for the wood blocks, which kind of making a more realistic physics for the falling parts, plus the macro animation for the character itself, and the UI elements animation, which is showing the points and everything else. I can do more and refine this project further, but I'm gonna stop here, and now it's time to go and see what ChatGPT and Claude can do. Okay, I will do the same thing with the ChatGPT and Claude in the next step. What I need to do is I need to export all the assets that I have in the PNG format and then import them into these tools that I mentioned. Of course, with the Figma Make, I didn't have to do that. I just had to copy the design that I had using the Ctrl-C or Command-C combination key, and then paste them within the Figma Make chat. But here I need to export them. Or we can use the MCP servers later on. In this video, I'm not going to use MCP server. So we copy that, give the prompt again. With the same prompt, with the same asset, we're going to see how the results are going to be for these two tools. In the ChatGPT and Claude, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to import all the assets that I have, including the scene composition, the illustration that I have from the trees and the character, and the same prompt that I give to the Figma Make. Here you can see the output of the ChatGPT Claude next to the Figma Make. Which one of these tools did the better job in your opinion? Share it with me in the comment section.
And that was it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share it with the other designers in my community. Let's learn together. See you in the next video.